Este edificio se movió horrible.
Horrible, tronó horrible.
Que se salgan, sigue, la pared se rompió. Sigue. Que se salgan.
Que se salgan, te va a caer.
Ana Pau, ven. Ana Pau, va a estar bien.
No,
no, no,
no, no, no.
Esto es frente a mi oficina. Esto es frente a mi oficina.
No mames. No mames, Tania, güey. No mames, Tania. ¡Esto, Dios mío! No mames. No, ah. ¡No mames, Tania! ¡Padre nuestro! ¡Padre nuestro! ¿Qué estás haciendo? ¡Dios mío! ¡Ay, no mames, no mames, no mames, güey! ¡Uy, no mames! ¡Qué pedo, güey! ¡No mames! ¡Ah!
¿Todavía? Sí, todavía. ¿Con réplica?
Sí.
Jesus also talks about a very important series of signs, one of which is in Luke 21, verse 25. And I want to give credit again to Mark Biltz for noticing this, and we're going to develop it a bit more, okay? So Luke 21, verse 25, without really reading into all of it, there's so much there. We just want to isolate the fact that there are going to be signs in the sun, first in the sky, and then the sea and the waves roaring. So this is the series, and then this has really been confirmed. And yet many people either don't know about it or know and just take it very lightly. On August 21st, 2017, there was the great American solar eclipse. And then 4 days later, this is something that I warned about, I spoke about. In fact, I did an end time conference in Houston just weeks before this event occurred. And even the location where I was is now not usable. It has been flooded. So there was a hurricane 4 days later, Hurricane Harvey. It cost over $180 billion. It was the costliest natural disaster in American history. 4 days later, you couldn't really get much more spot on. Why is all this happening? Because God knows, yes, there's some people who believe without seeing. Those are great. Those are better than the doubting Thomas. But there are also a lot of doubting Thomas around, and they're skeptics. And they say, I won't believe unless I see. Well, here is solid evidence. If you're listening to this, and you're looking for evidence that the Bible originates from another dimension, from another source, other than myths and human opinion, we've got it in front of us. Not only did the sign occur 4 days later, but the dates correspond to the chapter and verse that records Jesus' prediction. August 21st corresponds with Luke chapter 21. August 25th corresponds with verse 25. Could it get more rock solid than that? Not only that, God, who made the sun and the moon and the stars, made it such that the solar eclipse would draw a line, the path of totality across America, so that it would end in the Atlantic where Hurricane Harvey was starting. And then we have another hurricane that's about to make landfall, and it's probably going to hit the very end of the path of totality on the East Coast, somewhere in the Carolinas. Next, we have the great sign of Revelation 12. I said 9 months before this sign would be conception, if it was a normal 9-month conception. And sure enough, on the 23rd of December 2016, Obama pushed an anti-Israeli resolution. UN Resolution 2334 was approved, and it was very anti-Jewish, anti-Semitic.
Now, if you know your Bible, when Jesus Christ appeared, the Jewish people, Israel, said, nope, nope, we're not going to accept this guy as our Messiah, no way. So they said, Jesus is not our Messiah, we reject him. Well, you read the book of Acts, you see that it changes to this guy named Paul. And then God changes from dealing with the Jews to dealing with the Gentiles through the gospel of salvation. And Paul tells us in the book of Romans that his ministry ends with the rapture. And once the rapture takes place, watch this, then God goes back to dealing with Israel in the tribulation. The tribulation period is called the time of Jacob's, well, who's Jacob? Son of Abraham, son of Isaac, really, grandson of Abraham, trouble. So there will be a time in which God goes back to dealing with Jacob or Israel. And over here in the millennium, the thousand-year reign of Christ will be the kingdom of Jesus Christ ruling on the earth, the Messiah of Israel. So, could it be that this Revelation sign marks something to do with Israel? And we saw it on September 23rd, 2015 as a two-year marker. And God is saying, watch this, watch this, watch this. There's something coming on September 23rd. There's a sign in heaven, which I gave you thousands of years ago to look for, and that's the date that it takes place, and something big is going to happen for Israel during that time.
Then the birth pangs and the delivery of the king planet representing the king. Some people say, first, there has to be Antichrist. I got that. Maybe it's a representation of the false king first, but whatever it is, this is the king planet. So surely there is an Antichrist coming. Surely millions will be deceived. Whatever is being conceived and being delivered is going to be delivered around 23rd of September. So is this a sign that the rapture must happen on the 23rd? No, I don't know anyone who said that. And I think the mockers just, you know, this is called a straw man argument. You pick something that is ridiculous, and then you just beat the heck out of it and think you've won the debate. I don't think anyone has said that the world ends. No Christian preacher that I know says the world ends on September 23rd. But the sign, the symbolism, the metaphor shows that we are going into birth pang, contraction and delivery. All right? Is that delivering the church up to the Lord in a rapture? Well, then it could happen before or after. Is it delivering the Antichrist so that the world may be deceived? It could be as well. All right? But something major is being signified by this. And I think it behooves us to pay attention and not just to dismiss or even be ridiculing what God has made. So Jupiter is exiting after being in gestation. About 9.5 months, Jupiter has been in retrograde inside of the womb of Virgo. So we have delivery. Now, do we have any more confirming signs? Yes, we do. My goodness, we have sign after sign. In fact, we now have Hurricane Jose becoming strong and making landfall already in the Caribbean, and it's going to go to America. And I was watching Jose, but I didn't say anything because we had to give people updates on Hurricane Harvey, then update on Irma. But I had Jose at the back of my mind. I'm thinking, Jose, Jose, this is Spanish for Joseph. And then it just blew me away when I saw the next storm that is coming. The one under Jose is Maria. Maria, oh man, not only are these words prophetic, Hurricane Maria, they are going to intertwine in a rare event, in a rare dance that's called the Fujiwara effect. This is not something that happens commonly. In fact, I don't remember it ever happening at all, as far as I've ever watched the weather. And it's amazing because, as I said, Jose means Joseph, Maria means Mary. So Joseph and Mary, Joseph is on top, Mary's at the bottom, they're going to intertwine. In fact, Mary is going to pull Joseph back in. Joseph was a storm that was supposed to have gone away. Maybe it will go by the time September 23rd comes. But on the European model, it shows that Mary will pull Joseph back in. They do a dance and Joseph crashes in to the East Coast. And that can be from anywhere from Washington, D.C. all the way up to Boston. So another major natural disaster seems to be on the horizon. And the names couldn't be more prophetic. I mean, up in the sky, we've got the Virgin giving birth. Down below in the atmosphere, we've got Joseph and Mary. What are they going to deliver? Something major. America, it's time to wake up. Here's the headline news. Hurricane Jose and Tropical Storm Maria could dance the Fujiwara. Quoting from the reporter, Dan Stillman, you can watch Jose and Maria engage in the Fujiwara in the European model forecast below for Saturday morning. Get this, September 23rd. Can it be more confirming? Do we need more signs? Do we need more evidence that God is reaching out to America and saying it's time to repent and come back to the Lord? And yes, to the whole world, everyone that's listening, it's time to come back to the Lord. If you say, I don't believe unless I see, well, see it now. So many confirmations. It's going to start Saturday morning, September 23rd, through Tuesday morning, September 26th. Jose starts out due east of New Jersey with Maria due east of South Florida. As the two gets closer together, they begin to pinwheel around each other, with Jose slamming into the Delaware, New Jersey coast. This, again, is according to the European model, which, you know, in recent time, they say, has been more accurate. Do you want another sign that we are in prophetic end times? Guess what's happening this week? Jerusalem Post reports, Benjamin Netanyahu is to speak at the United Nations on the same day as Donald Trump makes his maiden address to the world. This is his first time as the ruler of the most powerful nation on earth, first time addressing the entire planet. What do you think these two have to say? Could it be a peace accord? Could it be the peace treaty? Could it be that 7-year peace treaty that Daniel talks about, that then in chapter 9 of Daniel, it gets broken halfway through after 3.5 years? I mean, this is astounding, the series of events that are happening all within a period of 7 days and within a period of just this month. How many more signs would convince people? The German philosopher Arthur Schopenhauer, who lived in 1788 to 1860, said this, all truth passes through 3 stages. First, it is ridiculed. Second, it is violently opposed. And then third, it is accepted as self-evident. Well, I think it's going to be very self-evident after Jesus comes that all these signs were supposed to help us to believe with real solid evidence that he's real. He's in charge of the universe, but he's not in charge of the earth because sinners have free will. So he's asking people to repent and believe him and follow him before the day of judgment comes. You can believe in Jesus right now. You don't want to be part of the mocking, ridiculing crowd. But the purpose of this video is to talk about signs. I actually did a whole hour teaching called Signs. That one you got to get. That one explains from as many scriptures as I can put into 1 hour about the purpose of signs, the function of signs, what do they do, what do they point to. That's a really good teaching. But this is a little bit extra to help you understand. We see danger coming and we're blowing the shofar. Like a good watchman in Ezekiel 34. God says, if you see danger and you don't warn, the blood is on the people's, the blood of the people are, is on your hand. But if we warn and they don't listen, then if they die, we're clear. The blood is on their own head. So we have a duty at this point right now to declare that the signs are here and confirm in multiple ways. And this Hurricane Jose and Hurricane Maria intertwining together, wow, what an amazing confirmation. Again, the European model says 23rd of September, on the very date the woman in the sky gives birth, these two intertwine like a symbol of giving birth to Jesus. That's amazing. That's confirmation after confirmation. That is just solid evidence if you're looking for it. I want to close by saying that I never said the 23rd of September is the end of the world. In fact, I specifically said there are two solar eclipses that will mark an X over America. And this first one has been confirmed by ending where Hurricane Harvey was brewing as a tropical storm, by ending in the ocean there, and also ending on the East Coast, where very likely Hurricane Mary and Hurricane Jose is going to smash in to the East Coast. It's amazing. Then there's going to be earthquakes, because he said, I'll shake the heavens and the earth. So heavens are shaken, then the earth. I'll shake the seas and the dry land. So more things are coming, and they're going to confirm that these signs are from God.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. This is a bad idea to be on this boat.
Oh, you're recording this, right?
Yeah. Oh, oh my gosh! I'm on the end of it on 1985 day!
Yeah, but that's the crazy thing. That's why I'm amazed.
Holy shit!
That is why I'm amazed.
This is the most interesting thing
I've ever seen. This is fucking surreal. It's amazing.
Oh my god!
It's surreal. What are the odds?
¡No, deja de matar! ¡Ah!